Hello friends, I Sunil Gupta welcome you at the platform of Edukemi. In the series of our YouTube discussion on academic subject, I am going to discuss very, very important, you know, part of the syllabus of the paper one, and this is called new public management, you know, new public management. So new public management is the topic. This is related to paper one, chapter number one. So I will just, you know, make the discussion upon few topics, few areas of new public management. What is the new public management and what is the feature of the new public management and how new public management is getting originated in public administration as a discipline. I will not make there much more discussion about the criticism and the relevant now this time, you know, but I will just, you know, make the brief discussion about, you know, these areas. So let us, you know, move for the discussion. Friend, new public management was evolutionary paradigm of public administration, evolutionary paradigm of public administration. And evolution has been taken place of public administration. In 1970, we have created, you know, new public administration, you know, very well. The new public administration has to focus upon the welfare state and it has to focus upon expenditure more than revenue generation. And later on, many countries had maintained the welfareism, had made much more expenditure upon this side, and then got, you know, debt crisis. And for this particular purpose, you know, in between, one paradigm came into being, what is called the PCP, public choice perspective. This public choice perspective has to say, we don't try to understand the citizen as citizen, you should understand citizen as consumer. Whenever citizen is going to understand the consumer, then you have to establish user pay basis relation with the citizen. At that time, citizen is going to act as the customer and the state is going to act as the service provider. Such kind of relationship you should maintain. And for this particular purpose, this PCP approach came into being, you know, in acceptance in the scholastic world. And for this one, new paradigm of public administration came into being under the influence of PCP. This is called the new public management. So basically, this particular paradigm came into being after NPA with incorporation of PCP philosophy in the public administration. This is the latest paradigm of public administration, we have to say. Second, it is assumed that, you know, this paradigm came into being in 1990s. And it went for the 21st century. The first decade of the 21st century was the paradigm of the new public management. Still, we are going to continue. Christopher Wood, one important person who propounded the new model in public sector management. And this person has given the term new public management. And for this one, this paradigm is being used for the terminology in order to signify the paradigm. Formally, the CAPM Summit, CAPM means the Commonwealth Association for the Public Administration and Management, was held in Canada. And under this one, then August 1994 accepted NPM as the new paradigm of public administration. Let us, you know what are the features of new public management. So friend, CAPM Summit has to concentrate upon five important features of the new public management, what we mentioned under the PPT. So first important has to say a performance appraisal. So other paradigm means the previous paradigm has to say process accountability is important in public administration, but NPM has to say not process, performance appraisal is important. We will have to do each and everything based upon the performance appraisal. Ayushman Bharat implemented, the process is important, but very important is the what is the outcome, what is the outlay. That is important for that. So without performance appraisal, we will not take any action. Any decision should be based upon performance appraisal. So the focus of new public management is upon output, not upon the input, right? Second paradigm, that second feature has to come under this paradigm, what is called the cost cutting in bureaucracy. So right from now, we have not to just, you know, make the investment upon the bureaucracy. We will have not to make any investment upon the public agencies, we will have to make, you know, the contracting out. Alternative mechanism we have to, you know, create. For example, you know, if you have to build the road, so earlier we have to make PWD department, right? Public Works Department is there. But now, if you have to make the road, then and thereafter, no need to have public work department, you have to outsource to the certain construction company. So these are particular fact is called the cost cutting in bureaucracy. Second important feature. Third feature is called the user pay basis relation. Iska matlab ye hua ki state and the citizen should not maintain the raja praja type of relation. They should maintain user and the service provider. A state should act as service provider and the citizen should act as user. User has given money and then you have to give the service in place of the money. So based upon that, there is relation of the user pay basis, not automatically citizen and the state type of system. So based upon that, it is just, you know, getting entrepreneurial character of the NPM regime. Next important quasi market approach. Earlier, we have not to concentrate upon the market in the state. We had some reservation about the market. You know, market should not dominate upon the system. But now this time we accept it. The market will continue along with the state. The state will be there, market will be there. We have to accept the state, and a state will have the minimum role as possible, as minimum as possible. It is called the state minimalism. And so this particular, so in order to just, you know, enhance the public choice, quasi market approach came into being. And the fifth important, what is called the managerial autonomy. NPM always favors managerial autonomy in order to enhance the performance accountability. So, agar autonomy tumne nahi diya, the accountability you cannot measure in very comprehensive order. So it is very important fact is there, management should be given the autonomy. It should be liberated from the rules and regulations so that the person can use the innovation of knowledge should be there, you know, and creativity work to be done under the public management. So based upon this one, you can say NPM is the paradigm that has to focus upon economy, efficiency, and very important, effectiveness. Effectiveness may be its focus. Earlier, you know, economy and efficiency was the focus, but now efficiency, effectiveness has to come under the NPM regime, right? Question is, ki NPM immediately aaya, or fir ye continue kar gaya? What was the factor responsible for that? You know, so our analysis has to say, so many factors are responsible for that. And first important factor responsible for that, what? Change in the functional role of a state. A state is getting changed from, you know, regulator or to the facilitator, controller to the facilitator. So earlier, a state has to do each and every work, but under the Reaganism and the Thatcherism, right? It was proved the fact here that a state should act as, you know, facilitator, and the role should be as minimum as possible so that the market should get a space for the development. So first important is their change in the functional role of a state, and so NPM has become the alternative for the state. Second important, change in government structure. The pehle ka government structure was strictly based upon the bureaucratic machinery. It was very rigid in nature, but we have changed the structure of the government, that is a very flexible, adaptive, organic, adaptive in character. So NPM seems as to be, you know, the adaptive paradigm for that particular time. Sabse important is debt crisis. Pure third world country or in general countries are going to face the problem of debt crisis because they have made expenditure much more than revenue generation. Ab state ko chahiye tha revenue generation from the different sources. How can you create revenue generation? Only by means of the promotion of market. And if you promote the market, then NPM regime seems as to be the great source for the development, right? So next important, it has to say here, one of the important impact came into being. This is called the LPG regime. Liberalization, privatization, and globalization came into being. And under the LPG regime, if you concentrate upon the market, if you concentrate upon efficiency, then NPM regime is not going to work. You have to change the paradigm. NPM has become very, very suitable paradigm for that. Technological change has been taken place. Earlier, manual technology, now this time information technology, information and communication technology introduced. And for this particular purpose also, you know, NPM has become one of the prominent paradigm in the system. And the last one, you know, the support of the scholastic school PCP. The PCP school has to favor institutional pluralism, people empowerment, market, public choice. These are the particular area. And so we have just, you know, inculcated NPM as the new paradigm of public administration. We accepted NPM as the new paradigm of public administration. But what happened to NPM? Some criticisms are there. some relevant mechanisms are there. What is the current status of NPM? I will discuss in the next lecture, right? So for the time being, I would like to say thank you very much. And I will, you know, meet you with a very short video in between. So thank you very much to you all.